family traditions. Some would call them preconceptions. For the most part, those traditions or preconceptions warm our hearts and put a smile on our face, but some of those traditions bring more spark, more heat than warmth. I thought it'd be kind of fun to give you a little bit of a pop quiz this morning, just to kind of get your input on some of these preconceptions or Christmas traditions. So, in your family, with the people you know, which is better, a real Christmas tree or an artificial one? Look at that. See there? See there? We got people have very strong opinions. Okay, do you open, in your family, do you open Christmas presents on Christmas Eve or Christmas morning? Wow, this side is stronger in their opinions than this side, by the way. Just saying. Okay. Here, this was a big argument in our family. What time is it okay to wake your parents up? Never, 5. Our kids always bargain. Okay, 4:15? Can we catch up at 4:15? As long as I can go back to bed at 4:30. Yes, yes. Okay, for your tree, is there a star or an angel on top? See there? Okay, that's a little bit more split. Turkey or ham for Christmas meal? Look at that. Wow. Okay, and this one's going to be the hardest one of all. I promise you. You ready? Ready for this last one? Is Die Hard really a Christmas movie? Yeah. Well, one of the prominent figures in the Christmas story that a lot of people have a preconception about. They've developed a tradition in their church affiliation about this person. It's Mary. Our Catholic friends tend to make more of Mary than we Protestants are comfortable with. Some of them see her as a co-redeemer right alongside of Jesus. Some see her as a co-mediator right alongside of Jesus. But then you have us, the Protestants on the other side. We make very little of Jesus. She was just a young girl with nothing to attract God to her, who just did something, and you know, let's just not talk about her too much. Well, I'm going to encourage us to put aside our preconceptions about Mary. And let's just allow the scripture to tell us who Mary was. And help us to form an opinion about her, maybe even a new tradition about her, that will be informed by the scriptures themselves. So you'll want to turn in your Bibles to Luke chapter 1. We're going to look at one of the key passages that gives us the limited amount of information that we have about Mary. If you don't happen to have a Bible of your own, there is a Bible in the pew in front of you, and you'll want to turn to page 715. That's where you'll find Luke chapter 1, and we'll start in verse 46. And we're going to, the words will be on the screen as well, but we're going to allow Mary to speak for herself. Luke chapter 1, starting in verse 46. I think they'll be on the screen. Maybe they won't. There we go. And Mary said, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has been mindful of the humble estate of his servant. From now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me. Holy is his name." First thing I want to point out is that Mary takes all the attention off of herself, and she points it back to God. She says, "My soul magnifies the Lord." By the way, down through the years, this song, verse 46 to 56